You have to get up close and personal and hear this man's voice. It's beautiful. So, I want to tell you, how many of you now, hold your hands up, please play along. It's important that we see the numbers. How many of you have ever been on a job interview? Actors, keep holding your hands up. Any job interview. This should be everybody, isn't it? Okay, keep holding your hands up. Play along with me. Keep holding your hands up. And for those of you who don't have your hand up because you're not an actor and you've never been on a job interview, raise your hand now if you've ever been on a date. Okay, now you can all raise your hands. That's pretty much everybody in the room. So here's my question to you. How many of you have ever had the finest version of that date, of that job interview, or of that audition be the one that happens in the car on the way home after the actual experience? Raise your hand if you can relate to that. Okay, that's called Monday morning quarterbacking. That's when you're going through the mental case of the woulda, coulda, shouldas, right? When you're thinking about, or the if-onlys. If only I hadn't done that, if only I hadn't said that, if only I hadn't worn that, well, how could I have been so dumb? Why was I late? Why was my voice quivering? Why were my hands shaking? Why was I sweating profusely? Why didn't I bring a handkerchief? Whatever. And suddenly in the car, you're a genius, right? You got it all figured out. And you're thinking, if they could only hear me now, if they could see this me, they would absolutely just hire me. So I came up with a technology that helps people. How are you, brother? Good to see you again. I don't forget faces. So how many more minutes do we have? Like, can I get this in 3 minutes?
We good?
Okay, I can do it in 4 minutes. So I'm going to warn you in advance that once you've heard this story, first of all, it's entirely true. Okay, there's no embellishment. I'm not building a story here. I'm reporting the truth. Secondly, upon hearing it, you will be firmly convinced that I need to promptly be institutionalized. But it's true. So, back 25 years ago, I'm reading for my first series regular role, and I tell my wife, honey, I'm going to ABC today. By the way, my first three television series as a series regular were all on ABC. All three were lasted less than 1 year, and I have decided that ABC is an acronym for already been canceled. But this was the first of those three, and I went in to read, and right before I left the house for the network and the producer round meeting, everyone that was going to be there, they called it a network meeting, I got one of those whispers. Uh-oh. One of those internal voices that just offers you a thought about what you need to do in this moment. Now, I am a whisper follower. I wish I had gotten into this earlier today, but in the interest of time, please come sometime if I'm in your city, wherever you live, doing my program, The Extra Mile. By all means, please come treat yourself to it. You'll enjoy it immeasurably. And I talk about the importance of following the whisper. And that whisper is that voice within our hearts that guides us and leads us and protects us. It is that voice that will tell you at a street light to turn left when normally you would turn right to go home. Well, you know what I'm talking about. Everybody knows this voice that says, not tonight, turn left. So this voice said, you need to go to the network with your shoes full of syrup. You heard me right. Syrup. And my wife, God bless her, she didn't question it at all. She went over to the cabinet and said, honey, how can I help you? Would you like Aunt Jemima or Long Cabin? Right to the cabinet. And we filled my shoes. We did. We absolutely filled them. Such that I was the only one at network that day who was literally squishing upon arrival. And I could hear it, and more importantly, I could smell it. Now, syrup is not an offensive aroma. And when I walked in, I was feeling so good. I mean, let's face it, Steve Martin, I'm probably going to have to go 1 minute over. But Steve Martin taught us it is impossible to be depressed while playing a banjo. Nobody goes, oh, death and murder and taxes. Nobody does that. So I walk in, and I'm in front of a panel of suit-wearing CEOs, corporate CEOs, and I'm a grown man whose shoes are full of syrup. And I'm loving it. And nobody knows why I have this radiant grin. Cut to, I got the job. This was after they were going, looking at one another. And I'm sure they were wondering, I don't think anyone has cologne made by Log Cabin. But I wound up getting the job, and the grocery store became my new favorite place to play, my new playground. Because I would walk the aisles with my wife going, oh, that would be so much fun. We could do this. And I started loading my shoes with items for every single audition I went on, including some of my favorite booking tools, bacon bits, my favorite little baby marshmallows, the little miniature ones shoved between my toes. And I gotta tell you, you just are not gonna have a problem when you have baby marshmallows. I'll wind up this story by telling you that I booked 6 jobs in a row. My agent said, I've never seen anyone book 6 jobs in a row in my career. I've been an agent 30 years. I've never seen that. What are you doing? I said, it's interesting you should ask. But I'm working on some new techniques, and they seem to be effective. And I didn't tell him what it was. And on the seventh one, I decided, if it works this good in your shoes... Wonder where else it might go. And for jobs 7, 8, and 9, all 3 of which I booked them with bologna in my undershorts. Okay, so I'll close by saying this. Make this your motto. Oscar Mayer equals higher. And one of my students, as I say goodbye to you, I will tell you, one of my students took me up on this and said, I'm going to do it. I've never had a call back in Los Angeles, been here 5 years. And he said, I'm going to try the food in the other shorts thing. He said it felt risky. I didn't understand that when you're 0 for 90. But he called me a week later and he had gotten his first call back and first job. And I said, don't leave me hanging. What did you do? He said, Glenn, I put an entire handful of Kellogg's Frosted Flakes between my butt cheeks. I said, outstanding. He said, have you ever done that? I said, no. He said, what do you think? I said, are you kidding me? Kellogg's Frosted Flakes? I think that's cool. God bless you all.